YouTube, what's up? Welcome back to a fresh new video. Today, we are not talking about the new PSA Plus mic. It's almost like the original PSA with a wetsuit on. They made a bunch of small changes to this thing, and actually those minor changes are making a huge difference. We're not here to talk about that though. No, we are gonna be today talking about the Rode M5 little pencil microphone. Got this one here, got another one right out of frame. As Dunna Did It likes to say, it's about a hang loose and a half away from my mouth. That's a good measurement tool, I like that a lot. And you get two of these, you get two. This one here, one above, for $199. The big question today is this gonna be my new microphone for the studio compared to what I used to use, much more expensive, of the Rode NTG5. Let's check it out. Notice a lot of videos coming out about the titles something along the lines of "Don't buy a shotgun microphone, you're buying the wrong mic." And I'm always trying to optimize my studio, make it high quality, make it really efficient. Always be thinking about cost and those type of things are pretty important. So I couldn't help myself but to explore this a little bit. Like, as an example, the Camera Conspiracies channel, who I wasn't always a fan of his style, but I gotta admit he's growing on me and I am absolutely a fan. Anyways, he dropped this video, and you should check that video out a little bit deeper if you want to find out why I was inspired by it to hit my friends up at Rode so I can test out their pencil mic of the M5. Because the truth is, I've always felt that using the NTG5 just for my YouTube studio was overkill. And I was filming with a friend recently and he had a couple of these M5s and I thought that they sounded amazing. So I decided to do some tests for all of you and overall make a decision between the NTG5, which is priced a lot higher than these M5s. Run a test and see which one am I gonna be keeping in the studio. Look, I'm not the audio guy and I'm definitely not smart enough to tell you about the difference between a polar pattern of a cardioid microphone like the M5 versus a super cardioid like the NTG5. But the test that I ran, I got some interesting results I'm excited to share with you in just a second. So why was I even interested in the first place of swapping out an NTG5 for a much cheaper M5? Well, back to that Camera Conspiracy video who references another video. I always felt like there was a little bit of reverb in my videos when I was using my studio shotgun style microphones. It's not perfectly sound treated in here. I mean, you can see the panels behind me. It's pretty dry, but I always felt there's a little bit of reverb, and that video from Camera Conspiracy was talking about how maybe the shotgun microphone's pickup pattern is part of that reason, so I was interested in that. And there's a cost difference, as I mentioned. And lastly, can the M5 in this type of environment give me at least as good of audio as an NTG5? With maybe even some better reverb. So simple today, running some tests, gonna make a decision at the end. The test setup is very straightforward. I've put each microphone, again, a hang loose and a half away from my mouth, just out of frame, and I'm gonna be normalizing the audio, and that's it. I'm not gonna be doing anything else, not treating the audio whatsoever for you to be able to hear the differences between, again, M5 and TG5. And just for fun, even if you don't like the test I'm about to do or agree with my decision at the end, I'm gonna be reading a line from Rage Against the Machine's Mic Check song, seems fitting. I guarantee none of you knew this line if you've heard the song. None of you actually knew what he was saying, but now you will. Mic check, ha ha. I be the anti-myth rhythm rock shocker. Mic check, ha ha. I be the anti-myth rhythm rock shocker what? Mic check, ha ha. I be the anti-myth rhythm rock shocker. Mic check, ha ha. I be the anti-myth rhythm rock shocker what? So after all of that, where are we gonna land? Well, I've been listening to the differences between the NTG5 and the M5 for a couple of weeks, not just in the audio test we just ran, but even listening to it then. The M5 is a better microphone for this situation for me. The audio seems to be just about the same. I didn't notice a huge difference. I didn't get a huge reverb benefit that I was hoping for, probably because the polar pattern pickup of the M5 is not the same as the Octava microphone that was discussed in Camera Conspiracy's video, but it's comparable to the NTG5. And the cost difference is insane. And for my YouTube studio, It's a perfect mic, plus I get two, which is pretty cool. And it's likely gonna be a better microphone choice for you if you're in a similar situation as this. With that being said, if you're in the field needing a location recording microphone for highly professional use, NTG5 hands down is the way to go. It's weather sealed, it's designed for that type of environment. The audio you get without running the test, I can guarantee, booming this in a professional setting versus booming the NTG5, the NTG5 is gonna annihilate this. But for me, my studio situation, M5 is the way that I'm gonna be going from here. But hey, that's gonna do it for me. My name is Sean DeWispelaer. This channel is all about the skills behind the art of creativity, photography, videography, gear reviews, tutorials. Me being full-time in the fitness industry, it's always gonna have a little bit of a fitness feel to it. So if any of that is something that you're into, do me a favor, subscribe down below, tell the algorithm what's up by giving this video a tap on the thumbs up. Hit me up in the comments if you have any questions or want to know further details about any of these microphones, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next video. Take care. See ya.